Whatever.
Ojisama to issho dattara, motto yokatta no ni na.
Itsu demo issho ni iru sa. Shinpai suru na.
Sou iu imi janai tte wakatteru desho? Mou osoi desu kedo.
Na. Mou ato modori wa dekinai.
Hey playmates, it's Aerostar, and I am simply in awe of what just happened in Chapter 16. I mean, for me to have the chance to relive the tale of Baileysh and Emma, it's been a real treat, especially since the last few weeks have been a bit of a whirlwind for me, and since the collab has been a little underwhelming, not because I never played Tales of Vesperia, but mainly because the amount of effort I think that went into the event itself pales in comparison to what we're about to discuss today. Please keep in mind that I will be talking about the full story of Chapter 16, so if you want to discover what happens yourself, come back later after you finish the chapter. I was astonished because my whole perspective of Baileysh changed after we got that full look at what really went down, because I think the translation in the hero stories didn't really do this entire story justice. Emma is in essence everything I thought she would be, you know, strong-willed and free-spirited, and in a way very naive in the fact that she acts before she thinks. I mean, initially, I thought Emma didn't really have a say in the situation, but it turns out that Emma was the one who suggested that she approach John Donk for the sake of Baileysh's revenge, and I'm telling you, I highly doubt she really thought that through and what that would actually mean. This is obviously evident in that she kept her relationship with Baileysh even after she got handed off to John. Yeah, I mean, she pretty much just does whatever she wants to do. Anger is a powerful and dangerous emotion and energy, and Baileysh, I think, in heart, is a good man, although he did a lot of illegal things, who let his anger get a hold of him. When he received the mysterious staff from the old witch, he had to learn to control his anger to control the mysterious summons from the staff, and I think that in turn allowed him to manifest that energy into something powerful. Baileysh didn't really know John, and neither did Emma, and Emma was the instigator in bringing both of the lives into the hands of John Donk for the sake of Baileysh. I honestly believe that if it wasn't for Emma, Baileysh would not have given her to John. You can clearly see his love for her as a person more than just his daughter. And now I'm even more hoping that Raquel is Baileysh and Emma's baby. Although ethically that would be wrong. I mean, come on, poor John Donk getting betrayed by both his queens, you know? That poor man didn't do anything wrong except like be good to his people and look what happens to him. By the way, did you know that Baileysh is actually younger than John? I didn't really know that John would be a lot older, but yeah, whatever. So, what does this mean? Well, for one, I'm pretty sure that Valer would have fallen out of favor with Baileysh since it was his plan to take Emma for John in the first place but ended up failing, and thus Valer doesn't really have a choice but to side with Carrie. Second, diplomatically, if Baileysh was, you know, conspiring to get revenge on the Jensens for Pedras, St. Rest's relationship with Pedras would have not been the greatest, as Baileysh would have done his part as the advisor to make sure of that. Pedas is most likely going to be added as a nation later on, since we already have heroes that have conflicts with this great merchant nation, like Yorm and Reed Marie, and it's only a matter of fact of when, and I have a feeling that leading from the St. West arc, we will eventually go into Pedas as well, as Esther's Republic will see a Khan and Matron, which by the way, their hero story also was an exciting one that I really want to touch on later on. Did you guys enjoy the story progression? I thought that tinting like the whole screen in like a bronzy like flashback color to show the past was also a cool feature for this chapter. Let me know in the comments below. And if you like random gaming content, especially on Exos Heroes, please consider leaving a like and subscribing. I post every Wednesday and weekends. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and take care.